Hey there, boys and girls. Welcome back to another week of Health and PE at Home. And this week is all about dressing for cold weather exercising and cold weather hiking. So when you're out there and you're in the elements in the outdoors, you are comfortable. It's not a dread to be outside. You're not freezing your buns off, and it is an enjoyable experience for you. So it's all about dressing in layers. So we'll talk about three layers for your upper garments, and then what you should wear on your lower garments as well. So layer number one is your base layer, and you want to make sure that the material is synthetic and not cotton. Could also be wool. And the reason why is because and here's my example here of my base layer. Okay, it's a Patagonia long sleeve shirt. And the reason why you don't want cotton is because your base layer is protecting you from moisture, and it keeps you insulated. It keeps all the heat inside your body. And if you wear wool, unfortunately, it's not very insulated. Moisture gets in and you can actually get wet. Okay, so that is layer number one. That's your base layer. Layer number two. I like to break down layer number two into two different shells, I should say. So I like to wear smart wool, so kind of like a fleece. Okay. And then on top of that, so say I'm hiking in the woods, I might just wear that fleece over my layer number one. But if I start to get chilly, or if it starts to get really windy, the wind chill picks up, or if it starts to rain, I will put on another layer, which is a jacket, like a jacket for rain, essentially, to protect you from getting wet and to protect that base layer. So a fleece for layer number two, and then a soft shell jacket. The last layer is your warmest layer, and that is just going to be a warm coat. Okay, so that's your third layer. When the elements start to get even colder, layer number three is you want to have a winter coat. Okay, so that's a little bit about the three top layers that you want to wear. Now let's talk a little bit about the bottom layers. So for socks, again, you want to avoid cotton. I love smart wool socks. It's a synthetic material. They're not too thick. You want to be careful with super thick socks, because if you have your shoes on or your hiking boots, if the socks are so thick you can't really wiggle your toes, you're going to get uncomfortable quickly. I love smart wool. It's like a nice medium layer for my socks. It keeps my feet really warm, really insulated, and protects from rain as well. I have my hiking boots on, which also protect you. They're rainproof. So smart wool socks are great for your lower layer. I also, when it's really snowy out, I have actually these cage-like boot coverings that I put directly over top of my hiking boots. And as you can see here, it has this like wire ring around it that when it's icy out, I'm not gonna slip, I'm not gonna fall. So these are fantastic when it's super, super snowy out. The snow's a couple inches thick. We wrap these around our hiking boots and we are ice free. We're not gonna slip in the ice. We also have these shells that we can wrap around the bottom of our boots, and those protect our ankles, and our socks prevent them from getting wet from snow or heavy layers of rain. They wrap, and you can tie them right around your ankles when you're hiking. These are fantastic for cold weather hiking. Another thing is gloves. So you want to keep your extremities warm. So we have like a thinner layer of gloves here that I wear, and then a thicker layer of gloves that you can wear over top. Also for cold weather hiking and even skiing too, protect your neck. You can even put it over your mouth and your nose, so you have like a neck scarf. And then obviously you want to keep your head and your ears insulated, so you want to wear a hat as the weather gets colder as well. So that's a little bit about exercising or hiking for cold weather to get yourself ready for the elements, so you can be comfortable, you can shed layers as needed, and it can be a really enjoyable experience. I always like to say there's no such thing as bad weather, just bad attire, the clothes that you're wearing. So start to think a little bit about what you're wearing in the elements when it starts to get colder out, and you will be good to go. You'll be a happy hiker. All right? So happy trails, everybody.